Hello and welcome. Today we're going to have a deep dive into our Olympic trophy and how SOLIDCAM Simultaneous 5 axis has allowed us to machine this. Let's first start by looking at how we can use Simultaneous 5 axis to relieve stock. In this, we have made a surface inside SOLIDWORKS, as can be shown here. We're going to use this to trim some of the stock left over from eye machining in a previous operation. This will allow us to do subsequent operations with ease and make sure that there's no stock that's going to interfere. With SOLIDCAM, we can easily use barrel or oval form tools, and that'll be an excellent choice for this toolpath. From there, we can choose a tool axis direction and the limits we may want to work in, as well as depth cuts and making sure that we don't cut any fresh air by using stock definition. As you can see, as we come to simulate this, we can see the toolpath playing live in action, cutting the surface model we've brought in and clearing up the stock so we can get on with our next operation. This really allows great flexibility to making sure that the design intent comes through into the actual machined part. Moving from this, let's look at another great technology with inside SOLIDCAM. Geodesic machining also allows for 5-axis toolpaths. The difference with this is we can have a look at the entire model or just a surface and ensure a completely constant step over between each individual toolpath on a multi-axis path. As you can see again, we can use oval form and barrel form tools to make sure we can get as much machined as possible as quick a time and assign things such as surface quality. As we bring this into simulation or seeing it on the machine, you can see this is a great way to form this radius on the top of the trophy. It's not just roughing and finishing Simultaneous 5 axis can be used for. Using the projection technology, we can also engrave. We can do this by picking a surface we want to engrave and then edges to groove. With this, we can also assign an offset to cut into, as well as describing the tool, the levels, and the axis control that you're all familiar with. From this, we can then go and see a toolpath again inside the simulation to verify it is exactly what we need. And as we bring this through to the machine, we can see parity between everything. Further multi-axis technology inside SOLIDCAM is Swarf machining. In Swarf machining, we use the side of the cutter rather than the end. We can define this by again picking a surface we want to work on and add additional information if needed, picking the tool, in this case an end mill, and then, as you are aware, picking the technology for the levels, the step over, step down, and axis control. This then gets brought through into the simulation to do one nice sweep to clear this up. Another great tool with inside SOLIDCAM's multi-axis is 5-axis edge breaking. This gives you a great set of tools to make sure your parts are finished perfectly. In this case, I've selected a series of edges, but you can also pick these automatically if that's what you desire. From there, we can assign a tool, whether it be a ball nose, an end mill, or even more, assign how deep we want the edge break to be, and then to go and simulate it. From there, you can see in this case, it's automatically created a 5-axis toolpath, but this could be locked to 3 or 4 axes if needed or required. With this all being said, we've seen some great toolpaths inside SOLIDCAM. The Simultaneous 5-axis can have great control as well as automation where required, making sure that we can machine what we need to machine. So with all that being said, thank you for watching and see you soon.